Hello everyone, in this video we will review Mac Mini, which is the cheapest Apple PC you can get new from the store, and see what this PC can offer in terms of work and even gaming. Here's Mac Mini 2020, which now costs $699 in the Apple Store and Amazon. This model has an M1 chip on the board with 8-core CPU and 8-core GPU. In terms of performance, this model beats most of the previous generation Apple computers, thanks to the M1 chip and software optimization. We have 8GB of RAM and 256 SSD storage, which is soldered to the board and cannot be upgraded. The only option you have is to buy an external drive, but I think 256GB is plenty of space for a regular Mac user if you are not working with big files. In the box, we have only Mac Mini itself with an AC power cord. It has a nice, small and minimalist aluminum case with all ports on the back. I also bought a keyboard for $16, which is universal for Windows and Mac and has a good quality and design, and a wireless Logitech mouse for $16. That already takes all USB ports, so I also got USB hub for $13, which turns one Thunderbolt port into 4 USB ports. I'm going to connect this Mac Mini to my 1080p monitor, and I was able to get 1080p at 144Hz. It's a small and quiet mini PC with a great performance. It takes minimum space and can easily handle your study, work or hobby related tasks. macOS has its exclusive apps and features as well. But what about gaming? Here you have two options. First, you can download game launchers such as Steam, Epic Games, Origin. For example, Steam has games that are available on Mac also. There are not that many as for Windows, but we can see some popular titles here. So you get to run them on the Mac Mini, and it works. Performance is not perfect, many games don't have a good optimization for our case, but it's enough to run some simple games. The second option is to get into cloud gaming. Basically, it runs game on remote servers and streams them directly to your device. There are several services for this. I will show you an example with Nvidia GeForce Now. After downloading the app, I logged in with my Nvidia account and selected free membership. Now I am able to run the games. They have a big game library and they are adding new games also. I tested some games and had a decent gaming experience. It's important to have a good and stable internet connection for this. Finishing up, thank you very much for watching this video. Share your thoughts in the comments and subscribe to this channel to see more tech content like this.